Well, it's finally warming up, spring's on its way, and I'm here at the fabulous Little John Lakes Fishery, where I'm gonna give you some top tips on catching carp this spring. Right, I'm just having my first put in here today. As you can see, I've got lots of nice features in the peg. I've got an island, I've got an aerator, there's a nice margin even. But I've just plumbed up on my line to start with at the bottom of the near shelf. Now, this is a line I really do like to target when I start my match. And as you can see, I've only put 3 pieces of corn in my cup. Literally, that is it. I've got a piece of corn on the hook and there's 3 pieces of corn in my pot. And all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna tap this corn in and I'm gonna see what's there. A lot of people, when they're faced with this situation, would maybe pot some baiting on the pole, cast their feeder out straight away, looking to try and catch a fish. All I'm trying to do is see what's in my peg and what's feeding straight away. Is there a fish waiting for me short? Because if there is, he's a free fish. I can get that 1 or 2 fish, let everywhere in my peg just have a little bit of peace and quiet. And it's all about managing your peg for the 5 hours. So this for me is a brilliant tip about not piling in loads of bait and just setting the trap for that initial fish. Like I said, I've just got a piece of corn on, my rig's dead simple. I've got a 4/14 inline diamond on with a simple bulk around 8 inches from the hook. I've got strong 0/17 main line, and I've got an 0/11 power line hook length. And that is on a PR 4/34/16 hook. So everything's nicely balanced. I've got an 11 hollow in so I can deal with anything I might hook. And I've just potted that corn in. I'm just gonna wait. I'm just gonna be patient. I've got no rush. I'd like to see what everybody else is doing. I'm not even gonna feed anywhere else in my peg for the first 10 or 15 minutes. Just gonna see what happens. If I can catch 1 or 2 fish here, it'll be a bonus. If not, I haven't done my peg any harm because I haven't been out and caught a load of fish or done anything different. It's all about managing your day and not piling in loads of bait at the start. So it's a great tip. Corn's a great bait to do this with as well. It's very visible, so fish will pick it out quite quickly, and you don't get pestered by small fish. So even then you've got a chance of hooking quite a big fish on this line as well. It really is a nice spring tip. Sometimes you can catch as many as 10 or 12 fish here over an hour and a half, and you haven't even had to go anywhere else. On those harder days, it might just be 1 or 2. This is my first put in, like I said, and hopefully I'll catch 1 or 2 fish. So it's been an interesting start to the session. I've actually caught 3 carp here. We're about half an hour in and I've caught 3 carp. But I did catch 2 of them quite quickly. So I've only caught 1 in the last sort of 15, 20 minutes or so. And I get the impression that I'm not gonna catch loads of fish here. Now, one thing that I'm not gonna do, or one thing that I have started to look at, is I've started to look at my next line. And my next line will be fishing a little bit further out, pinging with pellets. So in order to try and get that going a little bit, I've been pinging 2 and 3, just hooked one there now. I've been pinging 2 or 3 pellets that little bit further out. And what that's given me a chance to do, it's slightly built my line further out. Maybe I'll catch a few more on this. This will be my 4th. And it's been a great start. And it's been a great start to the session. But what I was gonna say, what I was gonna allude to on this line is don't give up on it. Don't think that after this initial period that that line is never going to be used again. Keep putting a little bit of bait on there. So now, once I move off this line, I'm going to keep throwing in 2 or 3 bits of corn all day, because sometimes this can be a fantastic line to come back on later in the day and give yourself another late runner fish. And you can see the sort of fish that you can start your session with here can really put you in a great position early on in the match. But if you keep that little bit of bait going in all day, it might finish your match well as well. It's a feisty one, trying to get under the platform there, but I think we're gonna get him. Lovely. So these are the fish I've caught. I've caught, like I say, this number four now, which is absolutely great. He's had that corn absolutely perfectly, look. Lost me a disgorger. I'll just about get it, I reckon. There we go. So what I'm gonna do now, that fish took a little while. I am gonna have a quick another look. It's gotta be worth another look. But what I am gonna do is I'm gonna keep pinging those pellets and we'll talk about that next tip. But just remember, don't give up on this line. Keep some bait going in there now all day, because this one behaves. A run of these towards the end of the match could make a massive difference at the end of your session. Noise, as everybody knows, is a real big factor when you're fishing on commercial fisheries. When the fish are starting to feed, they really, really do come and have a look. They come and have a look for the bait. They're listening for sounds of bait falling in the water. But what you gotta be careful is not to overdo it. You're not looking to feed loads of bait. You're just looking to create a little bit of noise, create a little bit of falling bait, and try and get the fish competing. So I'm literally just firing out a few pellets at a time. Not every single cast in, but I'm just firing out a few pellets, and you can see every time I float, so pellet hits the water, I'm getting an indication. So I'm pretty confident I'm gonna catch on this line pretty quickly, to be honest. And what's happened is today, I've caught those few fish short, but I'm using the noise as the main line to attract some fish. And there we go, there's the first one on it. I've got the same setup as I had on the short line. The only difference is I've got a banded pellet on an 18 PR36. Elastic's the same, hook's the same, float's the same, and the shotting's the same. So everything that way is the same. Just a small mirror to start with. Oh, hook pulled out just to the net. Got him though. Perfect. There we go. So what I thought I'd do is just want to show you the bait that I'm using, and just show you a few things that really help on this line. Come take a look. Now, pinging pellets is nothing new, but I just want to talk a little bit about what that means and how you can get a little bit of an edge on it. So first of all, why are we doing it? It's because of the noise created by the pellets. As the pellets hit the water, they make an attractive noise, which the fish come in to investigate. They know the noise of pellets going in, and they'll come and they'll root around and rummage around for the bait. What you've got to do is try and catch them. So there's a few things to remember. One, don't go overboard with a bait. Don't put loads of bait in. Don't be pinging great big pouchfuls of pellets. It's just not going to work. You get lots of fish in your peg and you're not going to hook anything. You've really, really got to feel your way into it. Threes and fours to start with, maybe upping it later if you need to. Sometimes I'll ping 20 and sit and wait for a bite. Sometimes I'll ping twos and threes all the time. That's up to you. That's you as the angler to make that decision. My rig is really simple. It's the same as the short line, a 4x14 diamond, 11 hollow. We've been through this, the bulk's down here. It's dead easy. The only difference is on my 8-inch hook length, I've got an 18 PR36 with a hair-rigged band on. Now, this is quite interesting because for me, there's two ways to attach your band when you're hair rigging. One is to have the band just set off the bend of the hook so it can move about and have some freedom. I really like that for when I'm fishing shallow. I think it works really well to have a bit of freedom as the fish are coming in. However, when I'm fishing on the bottom, I found it better to have that band closer to the hook. Now, rather than hooking the band and having the band come off, or having another set of hair rigs with the band a lot closer, all I do, once I've put the pellet in the band, is actually hook the band itself. So the pellet is sat right next to the band. Means my band's never coming off because it's on a hair rig, but my bait is right next to the hook, so I get a lot of clean takes when I pick up. That's a nice little tip. The next one is preparing your pellets properly. If you had some fishery pellets, say 6 mil, not every fishery, but some fisheries, the pellets, they tend to float. If I throw them in, you can see there at least half of them are floating. That's no good. Ducks and what have you are gonna come in. I don't want to be soaking the pellets to get them to sink. I actually want to fish with hard pellets. So what I've done today is I've put some of this pellet oil on, okay? And it's really, really interesting. It's described as a sinking oil, which I'm not quite sure how that works, because I always thought oil floated. But all I do know is when I put this on my pellets, they become heavy, they sink, and the oil itself sinks. A lot of people, when they're into oiling pellets, they use like a sunflower oil or something, and all that does is it floats, and it creates fish at all different levels, and you get liners and no end of problems. This, when it goes on your pellets, it goes down, it stays on the bottom with your pellets. And I know that the fish love to eat it, because I've caught a load of fish today on it. And I've caught fish on it when we tested it earlier last autumn. This has secured it in my mind today. Wow, the fish really like to eat it. So by putting that on, which I've done here, and I'll show you how to do that, you basically put a generous portion on your pellets, stir your pellets around, get them completely covered. I do that when I get on the bank. And then the final pellets that are here have got the oil on, and when they go in, every single pellet sinks. Absolutely perfect. There's some little edges. Get that feeding right, the hook bait right, and you feed right, and you're on to a winner when it comes to pinging pellets this spring. For our final spring tip, I'm going to show you something that everybody's seen before and everybody's used before, but nobody uses enough, and that is the maggot feeder. I've caught a lot of fish on this just in the last few weeks. I don't know if it's that fish have got a little bit wise to methods, or if they're not quite in the mood for pellets and maybe it's maggots that they want, but it really does seem to work well, especially on hard fished waters. We're on a venue that gets fished a lot. This maggot feeder's something a little bit different. So I always have it set up, especially as I'm going into early spring, that sort of time. It's a real killer tactic. I've got some maggots here. I've just got a 50 centimeter hook length, and that is 013 on this today, slightly heavier on the rod and line. And that is to a 16 PR 412, which I really like when I'm feeder fishing as a hook. I've just got two maggots on the hook there. And I've got a 15 gram click cap feeder. Dead simple, you can load that up with maggots, you're not gonna overdo it. The maggots will slowly crawl out and your hook bait's right there. I don't know what it is, it really has worked well, it's just free running. All the other setup is the same as any other feeder fishing on commercial. 6 pound main line, a 10 foot monster carp feeder rod. Everything's dead simple. I'm gonna be casting towards the island, but just that little something different, that something different from what everybody else is casting in, can sometimes make a big difference. So don't be scared to set that up. Well, we've enjoyed a nice little run on the maggot feeder. It's not been as good as the pole with pellets. That short pole produced a few, but that pole with pellets has definitely been the standout for me today. This has been nice to drop back on and catch a few fish. Don't think it's been a match winning method today, but on a day when they weren't on the pole, I think this could have been a real winner. All in all, we've caught some fish on all the methods. Let's take a look at them and get them back. We've had a fantastic day here at Little John Lakes. We've learnt loads about how the fish are starting to react now that the spring's here. That long pole's been the best for me, but I've really enjoyed some fish. On that maggot feeder towards the end was good fun as well. So I've got a nice mixed bag. I'm gonna have a quick look. We'll get them back. Let's have a look. Yep, there's a way of fishing there, all right. Look, we'll slip them back. That really is a proper fantastic day. What a catch. I'm really chuffed with that. Great day for spring. Let's hope a few more days like that are coming up. Follow those tips and you won't be far away.